Hi there, welcome to the second video of this course. Today I will explain you how you will set up your Jira instance so that you can start to use Jira software for your projects. So I have an agenda for this video today. So let's see what we will learn here. We will learn type of Jira instance, what is the difference between server and cloud instance, how to create cloud instance of Jira. So let's move forward to learn more about the instances of Jira. Basically, there are the two types of Jira instances. First one is cloud and the second one is server. I will tell you what is the difference between the cloud and the server instances and which one you should use if you are beginner to learn about the Jira software. So let's move forward to learn about the cloud and the server instances. Here I will discuss the cloud instance first. So what is cloud instance? In the cloud instance, rather than installing and maintaining your product on your own server, Atlassian host and set up your Jira application on cloud for you. So this is the cloud instance, and according to me, this is the best instance for the beginners who want to learn from the very beginning. It is very fast because it's easy to set up and get started in a minute. As soon as you sign up, you can start working and inviting the team member. In this video later, I will explain how you will create the cloud instance. And the second one is reduce cost. Yes, because it helps to save money on the physical hardware, maintenance, installation, support, and any other hidden administrator cost as well. Because this is a cloud instance, so everything is on cloud. There is no need to bear the cost of your own hardware. Third one is no need to upgrade. Yes, because on cloud, you get the immediate access to the latest version of Jira. So there is no need to upgrade the cloud instance. And the fourth one is security. It is very secure because Atlassian take the responsibility to maintain the security and compliances of your database and organization. So I described the benefits of the cloud instances, but I want to tell you one more thing about: you won't have the direct access to change the database structure, file system, or other server infrastructure, because you have a cloud instance and the Atlassian already set up your cloud instance, so they will not give you the administrative access. So let's learn more about the server instance. What is server instance? In the server instance, basically you install, host, and run the Atlassian product on your own hosting environment. So basically the server instance, those team will prefer who want to manage all the details their own and are able to handle the complexity of setting up and hosting the products on their own server. So if your organization is very big and you have the department of the administrator, they can manage the administrative task of the Jira or on the server, then you can go with the server version. But if you are working in a startup and you want to learn your own, then go with the cloud one. In this complete course, I will also use the cloud instance because, as I already told you, it is very easy to set up and everyone can access it from anywhere. But in the server instance, maybe the organization installed it on the internal environment, so you would not be able to access it outside the organization. But the cloud instance you can access anywhere. As I told you, I will explain the cloud version in this course. So maybe the people who are using the server one, they will see some differences in the UI, because the cloud and the server UI is different. In the server, we have the navigation on the top, but in the cloud, we have the navigation in the left hand side and many more other differences in the UI. So as I told you, the difference between the cloud and the server instances. So let's move forward and see how can I create the cloud instance of Jira. So for creating the cloud instance of Jira, let's go to the Atlassian website. So this is the Atlassian official website. www.atlassian.com. Once you will click on the product tab, then you can see the complete list of the Atlassian product, but here we will go with the Jira software. So now click on Jira software. It will take you on this page. You can try it free. So once you will click on try it free, then you can see three plans. And this is the cloud one. You can see try our product in the cloud, and this is a free 7 days trial period. You can go with any of the packages. So I will go here with this one. So let's click on try it free. You can see this is a 7 day free cloud trial, and it will give you the full access to all features. You can add the unlimited users and access to sales and technical support. So let's create the account here. So I will use my ID. And you can click on agree and sign up. Once you will done with the sign up process, then you will see this screen where they will ask you to check your inbox and confirm your email ID. So I will go to my email. So to verify this email, you can click yes, verify, and it will redirect you to this page. If you want to select what type of team do you work in, then you can, but for now I am skipping this. And you can see the URL here. This is a Jira course WebGentle that I have mentioned at the time of creating the account, and you can invite your team with the help of the email address. If you will enter the email address here and send the invitation, then the people will get the email, will get the invite, and they can accept and use this environment and this Jira instance. For now I am skipping this. And here they will ask you are new to and you are already experienced with Jira, then you can find out, but for now I am skipping it. This will be the next page. Here you can see there are the two type of templates are available. First one is classic template and the second one is next gen template. I will explain what are the classic and the next gen template later in this course. You can see there the Kanban, Scrum and the bug tracking, three templates are available, and these three templates comes under the software category. So if you will go and will select all type, then you can see there are many more templates are available which are related to business. I will explain these templates later in this course. So that's it for today. This is the process where you can create the cloud instance. I'll explain in my next videos how you will choose these templates and create the project. So try it yourself, and if you need my help and if you have any question, then please ask me through comment. Thanks for watching. Thank you.